Hello. In this tutorial, we'll extract motion from Plask, export it to Unreal 5, and retarget it accordingly. The goal will be to use the animation extracted from the Unreal mannequin. Upon completing this tutorial, you will be able to retarget other character assets by following the same steps. To start things off, import the video you would like to extract motion from. Since there's only one person, select Single Tracking. If you have MoCap Pro, enable Foot Locking. Next, we'll be retargeting on the Unreal Engine, so turn on the T-Pose option for the first frame. Name the file and click Extract to finish this step. Assign the motion to the mannequin. Check if it has been properly assigned and export it by selecting the FBX Unreal Engine option. In the Unreal Engine, create a file to import the FBX file you just extracted from Plask. Please refer to the Import option. You must ensure that FBX doesn't refer to any skeleton. Also, be sure to make FPS, Mesh, Animation, and Texture compliant for import to be successful. Deploy the character onto an Unreal scene you're working on. Let's retarget now. We'll create a few IK controllers for each character. We'll start with a mannequin from Plask. Open the controller for the mannequin from Plask. We have to configure here to group each area of the skeleton and configure the bone chain. Here, you must ensure that the names assigned to each bone chain correspond with the names on the other character's control setting. Lastly, select pelvis and set retarget route in the context menu. Now, repeat the same process with a mannequin on the Unreal or assign an Unreal dummy and create a controller accordingly for the mannequin we want to use. Again, we have to create a bone chain. Be sure to make the bone chain's names identical to the previous character. Lastly, select pelvis and select set retarget route in the context menu. Next, we'll create a controller to retarget animation from one character to another. To get this started, select the controller of the character you will send the animation to. Set up the character in this scene as such. Go to the Retarget controller and select the character that'll receive the animation in the Target option. All available animations will appear on the asset browser now, and you'll see an animation from Plask you brought over. As you can see, the animation is displayed incorrectly since the initial pose is different. So we have to adjust the target character's initial pose by rotating the bone for us to import animation from the T-pose. The T-pose is completed. Now, save all the updated files. Once you apply the animation again, you will see that everything works as intended. Extract the retargeted asset to a folder. We'll edit some animation by applying bone rotation on a few parts. Be sure to input the key accordingly every time you edit the bone rotation. Now we'll test the animation completed in the sequencer. Place both the characters with the animation in the scene. That wraps up this tutorial about manually retargeting animation from Plask inside Unreal 5.